Today, I will help you understand what completing the square is when we are trying to solve a quadratic equation. So let's take this for example, and usually we'll try to factor this. But let me tell you, this is not factorable. So either we solve this by completing a square method or use the quadratic formula. But today, it's all about completing the squared. I'm going to write down the steps for you guys and work out the question along the way, but I will also give you the geometry meaning behind completing a square, so you'll see. All right, here, this is what we want first. Notice that we have three terms on the left that's equal to zero, but what you want is x squared plus some number b times x, just these two terms on one side. And notice how I just wrote x squared, which I meant 1x squared. And if we go back to here, we do have a 1x squared, which is great. But you know, sometimes you might have a 3 here, then in that case, just divide everybody by 3 and then proceed. But we don't have to do that here because we have a 1 already. And then also right here, the next thing is plus bx, and that's this term right here, right? Plus 8x, that's good. That said, we don't want the plus 3 right here. In fact, the 3 is bad because with the 3, this is not factorable for us, right? So let's go ahead, minus 3 on both sides. And then we can just get x squared plus 8x. And right here, just leave a space for magic number, you will see. Again, the 3 didn't help. We are going to add a number right here to make this work. So leave a space. And this will be equal to 0 minus 3, which is just negative 3. So what number are we going to add? Well, I call that the magic number. This is a magic number. We are going to add the following. And there's a little formula there you have to remember. We take 1 half of this value b. And again, make sure you have a 1 in front of the x squared in order for this to work. We take 1 half of b and square that. So we have to work this out. All right, and then we are going to add the result to both sides. So let's see what we have in this case. We have 1 half, and our b value is 8. So 1 half times 8, and then square that. Work this inside out, 1 half of 8 is 4. Square that, we end up with 16. This is the magic number. This is a number that we have to come back here and add it to both sides of the equation. Now, why did I call this the magic number? Because it's so magical, it's going to help you to factor the left-hand side. And better yet, we are going to get a perfect square. So if you're an algebra person, you can just go ahead and factor it, and I'll show you guys the tic-tac-toe method. We see x times x is x squared, and then 4 times 4 gives us 16, and you see x times 4 is 4x, and then x times 4 is again 4x. Together, we do end up with the positive 8x. So that means we have the correct combination, and we can just say the factoring is x plus 4, and another one, x plus 4. So we can write it as x plus 4 squared. So you can just work it out like this, all right? But if you would like to just see the geometry, here I have that for you as well. Note, let's start with x squared, and then let's explain what that means. Well, why is the second power called the square? Let me explain. Let's say x is just some number, and in geometry, you can just look at that as some length. So I'll just say this much right here is x. In fact, when you have x to a second power, we are literally dealing with a square, because I'm going to draw the x right here as well. And then you can see that we are going to form a squared. And the area of the square is just x times x, namely x squared. Just like that. Next, we have plus 8x. So look at this as 8 times x. So it looks like we have to have 8. Let's say this right here is 8. And then the x is like this. Right? So this right here is 8x. Good. But this doesn't help. This is how we are going to do it. In fact, we are going to cut this in half. Like so. I cut this in half. So I will just have 4 right here. Right? And then you see this right here will be x. But this is 8x, which we should have 4x plus 4x, right? Don't worry, I will just put the 4 down right here. And I say this much is 4, that much is 4. And then, of course, this is x. We can draw the x right here as well. Now, what's the area of this rectangle? It's just 4 times x, which is 4x. Likewise, this area is just 4 times x, which is 4x. Together, we do end up with 8x. And once you put this down, you see that we're missing one part. Well, we have this little corner here. You see, we'll just have to add this square back here to complete the square of the big picture. Well, how much do we add? Here is 4. Here is also 4. 4 times 4 is 16. So we add 16 to it. And this is why we took half of b and then square, just like that. And if you have this expression, you can just get x plus 4 times x plus 4 for the big picture, which is x plus 4 squared. Geometry and just algebra. All right, the rest is very straightforward because this is equal to negative 3 plus 16, which is 13. Now to get this x by itself, we have to first get rid of the square. And to do so, just take the square roots on both sides, cancel this and that. And right here, don't forget the plus or minus when we're solving equation. So here we have x plus 4 equals square root of 13. Let's just leave it because we cannot break it down. So just leave it, plus minus square root of 13. And to get x by itself, we will just have to minus 4 on both sides. Cancel this. Cannot combine this and that. So finally, we'll just leave it. X equals this right here, negative 4. And then write down plus or minus. And then square root of 13. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the answer to the quadratic equation. And this is the idea to completing the square. So hopefully everything is clear. If you want to see more tutorials or examples, check out my playlist over there. That's it.